Hello there, a warm welcome. Duncan Wallace is joining us today, the technical director here from Chariot. Good to see you again, Duncan.
Yeah, nice to see you, Katie. Good morning.
Good morning. So before we get stuck in and talk about your news that's been published today, let's talk about the story, the Chariot story. Fill us in.
Yeah, sure. So, essentially Chariot is a company which is focused on transitional energy projects with a strategic focus on the African continent. And naturally what comes with that is sort of a strong focus on ESG credentials. And the company has really two pillars. Firstly, it's the gas business that's focused on our Anchois gas project in Morocco, which is a country which has a high dependence upon energy imports. The other key pillar of the business is the power side of the business, where we're focused on a largely untapped market, providing power to the mining sector, which is providing hybrid and renewable power so that mining operators can reduce cost, improve efficiency, and also improve their ESG credentials by reducing emissions. And the final part of the business is a green hydrogen project in Mauritania, where we're looking to help develop a green hydrogen market with the Mauritanian government.
All right. Well, let's talk about the news of the day then. So maybe tell us more about this post-well analysis that you've done on the Anchois-2 gas discovery.
Yes, of course. So the Anchois-2 well was drilled between December last year and January this year. And we made some announcement on that in the middle of January. And since then, we've been working on the post-well analysis of data gathered from that well. So wireline log data and also gas samples. And today's announcement relates to that work. So the first element we announced was an upgrade in the estimated total net gas pay found in that well. At the time of the original announcement, we had estimated greater than 100 meters of net gas pay, which compared favorably to the original Anchois-1 discovery well drilled in 2009, which had around 50 meters of pay. So since the announcement, we've been integrating the log data, and we've now been using interpretation methods which are correct for the reservoir types that we found. And we now estimate approximately 150 meters of net gas pay. So a significant increase versus our early estimates, which is obviously very good news for us. The other element of the work we've been doing is on the gas samples that we acquired during those operations. Now, we recognized at the time of the original announcement that we had to be, you know, cautious about making early statements around gas quality. We had to wait until we got those samples into the lab and we had them analyzed properly. And, you know, we're very pleased to report that the gas compositions are, as we'd anticipated, they're really in line with the Anchois-1 discovery. So that's 96% plus methane and without significant impurities that could be problematic, like CO2 or H2S, and a very dry gas, which is great for the development. A couple of specifics, which are the A sands that were discovered in the original well didn't have a gas sample. We managed to take a gas sample in that sand in these operations. And we also sampled all of the newly discovered sands. So that's the C sand, the M sand, and the O sand. And consistently, we have very, very similar compositions across all of the sands. Now, that's going to be important for us because it means that, you know, we can consider developing all of the sands through the same infrastructure and the same process facility because the gas compositions are so similar. So obviously, that's good news for us as we look to take this project through to development.
Okay, through to development, you said it yourself. So let's maybe talk about this next step. Duncan, if you would, walk us through it.
Yes. Yeah, so the next steps for us on the gas project are to continue with our plans to commercialize the Anchois field as quickly as we can. We recognize the timing for gas now, right now, is excellent, really good time to bring a gas field to development. That's both to deliver gas into the domestic market in Morocco and help to promote economic growth, but also the European markets, which are really just on the doorstep of our project in Morocco. There's a major gas trunk line that goes into Spain from there. And as we all know, the European gas prices and demands to diversify the supply of gas are more important than ever. Yeah. In parallel with that development, we are continuing our studies on the newly discovered sands to understand the size of the resource and how best we might incorporate those new sands into a development at Anchois, and also understand the undrilled sands and prospects near Anchois that have been de-risked through the success that we had at Anchois-2. So it's really, for the gas business, it's focusing on near-term cash flows, but also seeing how quickly we can accelerate growth from the upsides in the project.
And as we all know, if an investor is going to commit and invest in a company and take it on in their own portfolio, they've got to feel good, confident, excited about it. Why do you think Chariot is the one for them?
Well, I think already in 2022, we've announced success on all fronts, really. The drilling project in Anchois. We've also announced two major renewable projects to supply power to mines in our strategic partnership with TotalEnergies, to mines in South Africa and also into Zambia. So already we've had a lot of significant news out already this year, and we see lots more activity through the rest of 2022. So we've discussed around the gas business today. We're taking Anchois towards a development. News will come out of that naturally, and also progressing the upsides and reporting on that will come as part of the project. We're also looking to mature an extensive pipeline of projects on the power business that we will take forward, and also updates on the green hydrogen project in Mauritania, where we see an ideal place to produce renewable power as low cost as possible because the wind and solar resources are, really one of the world-leading destinations in Mauritania. So it's been a really good start to 2022, and we're hoping to continue, that excitement through the rest of the year. And I think it's important to state, we're not a single asset company. We truly are a diversified business across transitional energy, and we are delivering on that.
All right. Duncan, thank you very much indeed. Duncan Wallace there, the Technical Director of Chariot here on Proactive London this morning.
Thank you.